Yo, what it do, 2K fans? This your boy, Ju King, the boss, and today we're going to talk a little bit about the ratings. We're going to talk a little bit about the screenshots. We're going to talk about how none of that really matters going forward in the 2K20. Now, and as much as some people say that it does bring up some good discussion points when it comes down to screenshots and ratings and whether they improve this and improve that. Now, I don't want to take anything away from the artists that worked hard on these character renders, on these player renders. Every year, I think they do something a little bit better than they did the previous year. But as far as how visually stunning those visuals look, it really takes your, like, you kind of have to adjust a lot of settings on your own TV and game in order to truly see anything remotely close to that, because it really looks like more so color correction than it does anything else. I really wouldn't say it's a bump up in detail. It really just looks like more color correction. Now, don't get me wrong, there are certain facial features that look a little bit better, but it doesn't really matter. So you already know that if you played 2K in the past, and especially the past few years, like, most people really want to know about the gameplay changes, the mechanics, the my team, the my GM in some cases, and of course none other than the changes that come to my career, because the my career community is probably the biggest part of the NBA 2K franchise. Well, I won't say part, probably everybody has at least played my career once, and when it comes down to it, they build their biggest parts of the game around that. So moving toward the future, I was trying to figure out, like, if there's a better way to deal with the way they release information, because I don't mind the cover reveal and then the teaser trail. I think those are the great places to start, but there are other places where I really feel that we've come so far when it comes down to games itself and gameplay itself and visuals themselves, where it's like screenshots after that really aren't as prominent as they could be. And let's dive into why is that. All right, so I believe that instead of doing in-engine screenshots, I believe we need to replace those with player builds, and you could essentially do that without removing in-engine screenshots. So this is what I mean. You can take a Russell Westbrook and you can say, okay, well, Russell Westbrook to me is a playmaking slasher, which is a slashing primary, playmaking secondary, and you can say, okay, well, this is the Russell Westbrook build. Now you can showcase off, the badges that this build can get. You already gonna start getting hype trained up, but then it's gonna give you a more engaging question. So you can say, okay, well, which point guard build would you like to see us show off next? And a person can choose a player, or they can choose two different builds that they want to see combined at point guard, and you can showcase what that look like. Right then and there, you already start to engage your audience a whole lot better, because player rating reveals, to me, don't mean as much as you would think they do, because since 2K updates the ratings throughout the course of the year based on performances and everything, these ratings essentially will only apply for the first, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, after the game comes out, because once the season starts, anything can happen and anything can change, causing ratings to go up or go down. And then you look at the My Team community, when it comes down to it, they're going to be hunting for the 99 overall, Galaxy Opal cards, right out the gate. So as soon as those start to drop, like, the initial player ratings mean absolutely nothing, even a month away from the game itself. Like, very few players, well, there's quite a few players that keep their same rating for a couple of months, but they're usually lower down the card. But you have your superstar players that y'all are revealing ratings for that are going to change just like that. So it makes this really not that important of an engagement. But if you start off with those player builds and you showcase a player that has, this kind of build setup, people can be like, okay, well, that's how I can build my Russell Westbrook build. And then, they can say, okay, well, what's the Steph Curry build? And I think that's what I want to say, sharpshooting primary, playmaking secondary. So that was a playmaking sharpshooter. So, you look at that and say, well, I want to see that kind of build. And we already want 2K to be at a point where we can truly build players that are realistically comparable to the real counterparts of these players. We get capped off at every single step, but it's more on lines of, if you want to show us the way we can get the closest to this build without actually being on the same level as this build, and engage the community and ask the questions, because you see a lot of it on Twitter where Ronnie2K or whoever manages the NBA 2K main account, you would see them ask a lot of questions like, which player rating do you want to see revealed next? None of them, for real, because most people are going to play my team or going to play my career. Like, very few people are just playing play now. I know for me, when the internet is down and I can't play at all, I just don't play at all. So I'm not about to sit up here and play now, because there's nothing really rewarding in that. Now, for for myself, I would sit up here and say, okay, if you're engaging your audience this way, then all of a sudden now you're asking them about shooting guard bills, or you're asking about small forward bills, or you're asking about bigs bills. You can really stretch that out far enough while you patiently wait to drop, you know, the gameplay development blogs, the my team development blog, the my career, the my GM development blogs. You can really stretch it out so people have something to look at and look forward to, and kind of just increase the dialogue between the fan base. So instead of everybody complaining about whether or not some player has gotten a proper rating, everybody can be looking at it and saying, okay, well, I know this is the kind of build I want to build. I think this is the kind of build I want to start with. Now, we won't know that for certain until we have our hands on the official game, but having a sense as to where we want to start is always a good little, it's always a good little thing, because it all changes as the game changes. And the game changes over the course of the year. Some builds become, you know, obsolete. Some builds step up. Some builds become, was never good to begin with. But I think that if going in this direction, doing screenshots alongside the player build reveals, it allows players, it allows the gamers to truly engage with the product, and you keep the hype train building up. And that's the best thing about it. That's what you want. You want the hype train to always be on the incline. Never ever feel like it's ever declining. Like right now, the hype train feel like it's declining, and it won't be for like another, I think, week or so, where we start to get our first developmental blog to kind of go over, and you're gonna see, you know, 1,000,000,001 videos done about it, and everybody giving their impressions and their observations based on what they're reading. And that's the thing that the community really gets, you know, they really get hung up on that, because that's what information we want to know. But at least if you're doing player build reveals, you can hype them up along the way until you're ready to release those development blogs. And I understand that sometimes it boils down to you make last minute changes, but even knowing now what we know now, there's nothing that could really affect how we play the game. It just boils down to, I just want to find a better way to engage the audience, and always want to keep the audience wanting to see, what are we going to post next? What are we going to do next? What are we going to reveal next? You know, all the way up until we start seeing the development blogs, all the way up until we start seeing the first gameplay trailer, the first my career trailer, you know what I'm saying? The my team, you know, highlight trailer, before we start seeing all of that. It really is just one of the best ways to invest and engage the audience, to me, at the minimal cost, because that's the things that the audience is looking for. I got 2K news feeds all up and down my screens, always looking for something. And that is the best way to engage the audience. Don't get me wrong, there are a lot of articles being written about the player ratings and everything, but most of those articles, like I saw one article on NBA.com, and I know Damian Lillard said in an article that when they asked him, he was like, well, he don't really care too much about his player rating, mainly because he don't really play as himself when he's playing 2K. And I look at it and say, well, that's true. Like, nobody, like, even if you're playing my GM, you know, you're looking to improve the player. So those starting ratings don't really mean as much as you think, because you're looking to build these players up. And so it might be great to have this particular person as a superstar on your team for the build around, but you're looking to build players up. Every game mode that you play is about improving your team. It's never about just playing with what you got, unless you're talking about play now. So speaking on that note, I think the next thing that should be done is splitting up the marketing team just a little bit. And they probably already do it, but what I mean by this is essentially you got three teams: Team A, Team B, and Team C. Team A's responsibility might be promoting my team. Team B responsibility would be my career, and Team C responsibility would be my GM and my league, right? So if you got these three teams focusing on their specific categories, essentially they'll meet and see, you know, what each one of them are going to talk about. But when it comes down to what information that they pull out, it's like, okay, look, this is going to be dedicated toward the my GM community, the people who like the my GM mode as their favorite mode. This is going to be dedicated to the my league, the my team community. The my team community, you know, big part of the 2K community. So this is going to really gravitate toward them, whether it's an article, or whether it's the way the cards are going to look this time around, or whether it's a new feature that they're bringing in. We all like to read all of those articles that drop and get all of that information that drops. But just by breaking up the teams a little bit, you all of a sudden now can really feed your audience in a more clean way. You know, as much as they say they're doing things differently, it really feels like they're doing things the same this year when it comes down to how they're promoting. We already had the cover reveal, we've had the teaser trailer, we're getting the screenshots, and then we got the player ratings. The next thing that we're going to start seeing is the developmental blogs within the next week or so. So I look at it and say, if they was to break up their team, it wouldn't look as such a, you know, copy and paste from last year, you know, copy and paste from last year when it comes down to how they market the game, especially because we're only around the corner from a brand new system coming out. So it's going to be one of those things where you'll be able to use this next year when promoting for the next generation of system. But because in that point, then the visual is going to look different. At that point, then, you know, everything's going to play a little bit different, you know, with the new systems. But right now, it's more on lines of like, we care more about the features. We care more about this. We care more about, we want to know what's going to happen when we get our hands on it. So breaking up these teams allow us to be fed that information in a more organized way. And to a point where we'll know, okay, when to expect some more my team news, when to expect some more my career news. Right now, it's just like you wait for an article, and then whatever that article is, it is what it is. It might be talking about my team. It might be talking about my GM. It might be talking about my career. It might be talking about just one little change on the back end. We look forward to it. But having a cleaner release schedule for information, having a more organized release schedule for information. And more organized doesn't just mean the time frame in which you release it. It also means that what's being released when. So their organization has pretty much been the same. And I would love to see a little change happen there. And I think it really does boil down to breaking up the teams a little bit so that way they feel like you're getting more refreshed information, feel like you're getting more new information. The hype train to me hasn't started. It won't start for, another 2 weeks. You know, because we're still in the player ratings reveal. So I think the next thing we're going to start to see, we're going to see that first look, my career trailer. And then we'll start to, no, the first look, my career trailer won't come out until around the time that the my career article come out. So we're going to get that, you know, that first look gameplay trailer, that actual first look gameplay trailer. And then we're going to start to see the articles that are talking about the gameplay changes and the mechanics and the AI and the back end. And then we'll start to see the articles about the my team and the my GM and my career. And the problem with that is that because we know when to expect it, you're really not hyping nobody up. And I mean, to me, you could hurt your numbers. I won't say that oh yeah, 2K gonna sell worse this year than it did last year. No, 2K usually does well every single year. You ain't taking that away from them. But the order in which you release information does build the hype and keep it in the mind of the player. And that's what I wanna see change. I wanna see the hype train change so that way the players are looking more and more toward the next product while they plan the current product. So there you have it. That's my take on the whole situation. I think that 2K needs to find a better way to promote the product, mainly because visuals aren't going to change by much until the next generation. So, you know, let me know down in the comments below. Do you think that there's a better way? Do you think there's another way that 2K could promote the product that would apply to you? You know, that would hype you up, that would get you more inclined to follow and want to know what's going on 2K from 2K themselves. And let me know down in the comments below if you're hyped or you're not that hyped about the game at all. You know, and tell me why. And as always, it's your boy, Juke King the Boss. I'm going to catch you guys in the next one. Peace.